has the highest individual credit card usage in the world. We look at what made credit cards an essential part of Koreans' lives. The global financial market is shaking amid predictions of the United States' announcement of an exit strategy. What is an exit strategy, and how does it affect the Korean economy? The voice recognition technology that finds the right information through voice command. We introduce everything about voice recognition and how it has progressed from the past. There is a product that maintains nutrients inside natural ingredients. We visit the food drying machine maker with global recognition. South and North Korea went their separate ways after the Korean War. How did North Korea's economy change 60 years after the Korean War?
Hello, I'm Andrew Salmon, and welcome to Bizline. We're coming to you today from Children's Grand Park here in Seoul. We've got a packed show. We'll look at everything from the effect of US quantitative easing on the South Korean economy to voice recognition software and Korea's credit card culture. So stay with us. But before we go to those stories, let's take a look at all the breaking business and economic stories hitting the headlines here in South Korea this week.
The Korean government and the ruling Saenuri Party have agreed to quickly push ahead with legislation aimed at protecting the domestic market from the impact of the U.S. Fed's decision. At an emergency economic meeting, the two sides decided to speed up efforts to revitalize the Korea New Exchange, or KONEX market, a third stock trading platform focused on small business ventures that's set to open on July 1st. In the first quarter of the year, Korean mobile DRAM makers dominated the world market, with 7 out of 10 being made in Korea. According to market researcher iSupply, Samsung Electronics was the leading manufacturer, shipping out nearly 1.2 billion mobile DRAM chips in the first 3 months of the year. These account for nearly 50% of the global market, putting the tech giant at the forefront. The sales of air conditioners are up more than 160% compared to last year, and dehumidifiers by more than 900%, according to industry sources. Dehumidifiers are flying off the shelves in part because they reduce humidity in the air by 5% and consume only a fifth of the electricity that air conditioners do. U.S. market research firm Strategy Analytics says the Korean firm sold over 9 million tablet PCs worldwide in the first quarter of this year, up from just 2 million units in the same quarter last year. Samsung's market share also ballooned to roughly 19% in the first quarter, up from 7.6% a year earlier. Korea and Japan have decided not to extend their $3 billion currency swap deal. The Bank of Korea says the two sides agreed to let the bilateral swap line expire on July 3rd. After the deal expires, the two countries will only have a $10 billion currency swap agreement signed with China and Southeast Asian countries under the Chiang Mai Initiative.
In 2011, South Koreans ranked first in the world when it came to individual use of credit cards. What is behind South Koreans' remarkable propensity to pound their plastic? Originally, government promoted credit card use in a bid to upgrade financial transparency, and that backfired with the credit crisis a decade ago. Happily, that crisis is now long past, and Korea is now home to pretty remarkable credit card infrastructure. In this report, we'll be taking a look at the what's and the why fors, the pros and the cons of Korea's credit card culture.
Credit cards are made of plastic, but it carries a great meaning to its holder. It allows shoppers to buy goods and services on credit. This convenience system was first introduced in South Korea in 1969, and its usage has grown noticeably over the years. The latest global data shows that individual Koreans use credit cards to pay for goods and services more than any other country in the world. But frequent use of this piece of plastic had a huge impact on the Korean economy a decade ago, bringing the country to an economic slump, and there were some hard lessons to be learned. So why do Koreans use credit cards so often, and what's the trend? Is everything they buy on credit card?
그 신용카드를 많이 결제하게 되는 이유가 현금 가지고 다니는 것보다는 편한 것 같고요.
I mean, you can use it everywhere, and there is no minimum most of the time, so it's really convenient.
70-80% 정도까지는 거의 신용카드로 결제를 많이 하세요.
The latest data released by the Bank of Korea showed that South Koreans on average use credit cards 129.7 times a year to pay for goods and services, which far exceeds countries next in line, such as Canada, which was 89.6 times. So, is there a special reason for this phenomenon?
한국은 정말 그 어린아이들이 그 과자 하나 살 때, 뭐 일반인들이 택시 탈 때도 정말 카드 결제가 가능한 그런 나라이거든요. 그래서 뭐 이용의 편의성 측면에서는 세계 어디와 비교해서도 가장 뛰어난 편한 나라라고 생각합니다.
The credit card system was implemented in the late 1970s, and Koreans found it to be an everyday necessity around the 1988 Seoul Olympic Games when large conglomerates such as Samsung and LG entered the market.
저희 IMF 이후에 그 경제가 아무래도 불황에 처하다 보니까 그 내수 진작을 하고 또 세원 노출을 하기 위해서 정부에서 신용카드 복권제를 도입을 했습니다. 그래서 신용카드를 사용하는 경우에 또 나중에 이제 결제를 할 수 있다라는 이런 장점도 있었던 반면에 이제 많은 분들이 이제 복권 이런 부분에 조금 그런 거를 이제 계기로 해서 그래서 신용카드가 굉장히 빠른 시간 내에 생활 필수품으로 자리를 잡게 된 것 같습니다.
The credit card lottery was run by the National Tax Service from 2000 to 2006 and picked winners every month, awarding around $85,000 to the biggest winner. That wasn't all. The government also provided tax incentives on credit card use. However, the use of credit cards became too excessive and the country did suffer in 2003. People learned why one needs to be careful in using credit cards the hard way.
그때 당시로는 카드 무자격자에 대해서 신용카드를 남발한 좀 경향이 있었고요. 지금 같은 경우에는 카드 자격 기준을 굉장히 엄하게 운영을 하고 있고 또 금융상품의 경우에도 한도 부여 이런 것들을 리스크를 잘 관리하고 있기 때문에 앞으로 2003년과 같은 신용 대란은 없을 것이라고 이렇게 생각을 합니다.
The financial authorities also have worked to provide safety measures as to not let such a disaster reoccur and hamper Korea's economic growth.
다행스러운 것은 그동안 그 감독 당국이 카드사들의 어떤 자산 건전성 재고를 위해 어떤 많은 선제적인 조치들을 했습니다. 그래서 이러한 결과로서 대손충 당금 적립액이 그 연체 채권의 한 3.4배 정도 이렇게 그 어떤 충분한 어떤 그 흡수 능력 이런 것들이 있다고 보여집니다.
And in terms of the total amount being spent by South Koreans, swiping the credit card so often doesn't necessarily mean that money is being overspent. Although South Koreans make the most use in credit card payments, economic slowdown has caught up and the total amount of credit card payments has dipped and been slow in rise. As of May, the amount of card payments made in the domestic market totaled $41.2 billion, which was an increase of 3.4% from the preceding month. To support domestic consumption, but still not escalating worries of payment default, the Korean government is endorsing another means of card payment, a check card, paying for goods and services with a card, but the payment is settled instantly as it is connected to the user's bank account.
신용카드 부분이 카드 소비를 조금 진작한다는 긍정적인 측면도 있었지만은 아무래도 과소비를 유발한다든가 이런 그 부정적인 효과도 좀 있었습니다. 그래서 체크카드의 경우에 정부에서도 그 소득 공제율을 일반 신용카드에 비해서는 2배 이상 이렇게 제공을 하고 있기 때문에 소비자들도 신용카드보다는 체크카드를 사용하는 것이 이제 나름대로 혜택이 있다고 생각을 하고요. 그래서 체크카드의 사용 비중은 앞으로도 점차 늘어날 것으로 그렇게 보고 있습니다.
The financial authorities announced policy to accommodate soft landing of household debt by circumventing the use of credit cards while encouraging use of check cards.
최근 들어 체크카드 발급 매수가 1억 장을 넘었습니다. 신용카드 발급 매수가 지속적으로 떨어지는 것에 비해서 체크카드는 발급 매수도 증가하고 이용 실적도 계속해서 늘고 있습니다. 지금 현재의 우리나라 상황, 가계부채 위험이 항상 상존해 있고 이런 상황을 고려해서 봤었을 때 이것은 바람직한 정책 방향이라고 생각하고요. 이것이 우리나라 경제의 건전한 발전을 위해서 분명 큰 기여를 할 것으로 보고 있습니다.
A credit card. It is convenient to have and probably one or two belong in everyone's wallet. However, there is always a risk to its use, so the government will need to maintain policy to support proper use as it is deemed effective in sustaining domestic consumption.
There are currently strong indications coming from the United States that with the economy in apparent recovery from the aftermath of the 2008 global financial crisis, it is now time to halt the policy of quantitative easing and restrict money supply. These indications are sending shockwaves through global financial markets. Here in Korea, there is significant fear that this could cause a plunge in the market. So what should Korea do to save itself from the side effects of this significant US exit strategy? These are some of the questions we are here to ask. We're at Sejong University with Professor of Economics Lee Jung-un. Professor Lee, thank you for joining us here on Bizline.
Thank you.
Okay, let's get started. Now, the Korea Center for International Finance has called the American exit strategy from QE a major threat to global financial markets. Now, basically, what is quantitative easing and what is an exit strategy from QE?
Actually, the quantitative easing is usually done during the crisis or in deep, serious depression. Mm-hmm. So it becomes the very trendy word since 2008. Mm. Actually, the central banks monitor expansion by buying financial assets, mainly national bonds. So for example, Federal Reserve Bank, they implemented three times of QE since the global financial crisis. And Bank of Japan, they has done increased the liquidity in circulation since in January this year, up to 13 trillion yen on the monthly basis.
Okay, and so this basically expansion of monetary supply, what is an exit strategy from QE?
Exit strategies, that means actually the risks arise in the asset bubbles and inflation because the excessive liquidity is likely to flow into the real estate market and stock markets. So they want to avoid these risks. So that's why at some point we need to exit. But the problem is when's the right time?
Mm. Exactly. But isn't it good news that the United States now senses that its economy is on the up? So now perhaps it is the appropriate time to implement an exit strategy. Good news or bad news?
I think it's bad news because actually the U.S. economy has not achieved her target rate of unemployment rate and inflation rate, 6.5% of unemployment rate and 2% of inflation rate. So it's too early to say so, but there is some possibility that the Governor Bernanke might have detected the symptoms of another asset bubbles. So he possibly realized that the more QE is not able to boost the real side of the economy any longer. So he might want to send a signal to the market. That's one possibility.
That's one possibility. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's Bernanke's point of view. But of course, he is facing some criticism inside the US that now is not the time. And from what you just said, I get the sense that you may perhaps agree. What do the critics say against an exit strategy at this time?
I think this is a matter of timings.
Yeah.
So it's too premature, just causing the volatility in the emerging markets. Mm. So it's not good for everybody.
Right.
So that's the main criticism about the exit strategy. But there is some possibility that, as I said before, the Bernanke wants to send a signal that we don't want QE anymore because we don't want another asset bubbles, we don't want another deviation from the economic fundamentals. Mm. Because this deviation between financial sector and real sector is the major cause of every single financial crisis. So he might want to avoid this.
Okay. What would you consider to be the key conditions for a risk-free exit strategy?
The desirable condition is that we need to exit on condition that real side of the economy should respond positively in the form of more employment, higher consumption, and more investment. But without that, it's just causing the volatility or fluctuations in the financial markets.
So do you believe those conditions have not been met thus far?
Not yet, unfortunately.
Not yet. Okay, what effect will this, we're talking about the US economy, a massive, mm-hmm. the center of gravity of the global economy. When the US does make a move, does tighten its monetary mm-hmm. supply, what damage will that have outside the United States on emerging markets such as Korea?
Okay, if US tightens monetary line, so then capital is likely to flow out from the emerging economies. So it will plunge of the share prices and bond prices, and it will discourage consumption through wealth effect, and also discourage investment through rising cost of funds. So it will damage the growth engine of the emerging economies.
Okay. Now, here in Korea, the Minister of Strategy and Finance and the Bank of Korea are showing concerns about a possible financial crisis sparked by this American exit strategy, which we're expecting to see this year. This sounds like real crisis talk. Is this fear truly merited?
I think it's unlikely it happens to Korea because we have learned a lot from the last financial crisis. So now we keep low level of short-term foreign currency debts and high level of foreign reserves. And even we have a very good record of fine-tuning of the capital controls. Mm. So it was very successful from the onset of the financial crisis to 2010. It was basically based on the research by Professor Shin Yeon-sung. And also, it's very important to keep our economy growing with fairness, forge ahead, because now the stock market is moving very much by psychological factors rather than fundamentals. So more or less, but sooner or later, they will come back because they have to optimize their portfolio again without fear. So we need to wait and see. And remain intact from the financial volatility.
Okay, well, I'm glad you're psychologically tough on this because obviously some investors are rather shaky at the moment. I think from June 10th till June 14th, there was very significant volatility here. We saw a massive outflow from Korea. What is behind that exit of funds? Was it purely psychological?
I think it's a combination of the low dividend rate of Samsung Electronics and the negative report of one security house and then short stock selling and then plunging share prices. So it's a little bit regrettable because the report is the logic is based on the weak demand and the slowdown of the world economy and the world semiconductor markets. So if this reason is so such a macroeconomic one, then it's not enough reason to target against just one company like Samsung Electronics. So this unfortunate event also poses the Korean economy the task of having world-class level banking sector.
The bank, right, we'll come to that in a moment because that relates back to the 1997 economic crisis here and the question of whether South Korea has exited that crisis. But let's return to Samsung's. This is a very controversial issue at the moment. In your personal opinion, was the plunge in the Samsung stock price caused by the macroeconomic factors we're talking about here, US quantitative easing, withdrawal, psychological impact on investors? Or was there another issue behind that? Some would say that perhaps this is a psychological game being played by foreign investors who want to see higher dividend payouts from Samsung Electronics.
I think this is the combination of all what you have mentioned.
Okay. The chairman of the South Korean Financial Services Commission has said it's time for Korea to implement preemptive countermeasures against the exit strategies from QE of advanced nations, which course, are not just limited to the US, but also at some point in the future, the EU is expected to do the same, and eventually even Japan will be doing the same thing. Realistically speaking, what countermeasures can South Korea take to shield itself from the after effects of these global financial shocks?
Well, strictly speaking, it's not really a countermeasure.
Okay.
We can closely monitor the foreign currency funds, and we can smooth operation in foreign exchange markets. In addition to that, maybe a few days ago, government announced the reduction of issuance of long-term government bonds, 10-year government bonds, so we can minimize the crowding out effect in the investment, and we can minimize the risk of rising interest rates. So that's a little bit passive ones, but as I said before, we have a great experiences how to fine-tune the capital flows in and out. And also, more fundamentally, we need to keep our macroeconomy robust enough. That means not just only to make macroeconomy aggregate index look good, to make every sector in the microeconomic issues should be reserved, including privatization and so on, including economic democracy and then the balance between democracy and economic growth and so on. And also, it's quite important, there is a joke that Korean economy is overall the automated teller machine.
Sorry, say that again?
Automated teller machine,
an ATM.
Okay. You know, in terms of capital outflows. But because of that, thanks to that, I think it facilitates capital inflows as well. So to remain intact from any financial volatilities, we have to keep growing the economy with the fairness, like in the name of economic democracy. And also, it's another suggestion is that we have to attract oil money, Middle East funds as well, without consideration of religious differences. After the Jasmine Revolution, it's quite a threshold event in the Middle East. This reason becomes more and more promising, even if there are many bombs ahead. So these regions, funds, oil money, or Middle East money is quite a good diversification from the Korean economic perspectives. So we need to think about that, because this economy is not easily moved by the factors in the advanced economies.
Right. You know, I do question whether this fear in Korea is merited. After all, if the Americans do exit QE, that indicates their economy is on the up. If their economy is on the up, that is rather good for the Korean economy in a sort of reverse way, because Korea's economy is based very much on exports. So although there is this short-term fear about the US exit, I think long-term, doesn't that mean good things for the Korean economy?
If the US economy really shows the vitality, it's a good sign for the Korean exporters. As you said, in the short term, if just US economy is tightening the monetary policy, that means the Korean won becomes weaker, and this could be in the short term could be a good news for the Korean exporters. But eventually, the most important thing is the scale factor. So, if the in terms of scale, the purchasing power of the U.S. economy should increase for us to really witness the increase of our exports.
Okay, well, fingers crossed on that one. But let's talk about the bigger issue of exit strategies from financial crises. Korea has arguably weathered the 2008 financial crisis. But what about the real ground-shaking crisis for the Korean economy, which was 1997, 1998, when the IMF had to come in? Now, even today, Korea arguably has not exited that crisis. The government still owns a range of assets, Woori Financial Group, a whole range of Daewoo assets and so on, worth billions. When will South Korea be able to exit the 1997 crisis?
It's an excellent question. So you are asking the exit strategy of our Korean economy.
Is there an exit strategy?
To truly exit from our past crisis in terms of nationalized asset, as you mentioned, I think it really depends on our privatization. It depends on our capacity to form a social consensus. Actually, Korea really needs the world-class banking sector. So banking sector like Woori Financial Group should be privatized as soon as possible. We cannot waste time anymore. So to achieve this, I think someone who can lead and mediate people or trusted by people should decide, not just leave it as it is for the political fear or political reasons. Actually, in terms of privatization, every decision is about human resource affairs. Who could be the CEO? Who could be board of executive? Or who could stay as staff and so on. All these issues are human resource affairs, so there is no privatization that can satisfy everybody. So I think someone should decide and someone should tell the direction and scope and procedure, and then we have to upgrade the Korean banking sector with not in terms of size, but also in terms of skills and networks and even philosophy. So I want to see that in the near future, and at that point we can really exit from the financial crisis.
Well, let's hope so. But the MB government, the Lee Myung-bak government, were talking about privatizing this giant Woori Financial Group, which was, of course, a child of the crisis. It's a conglomeration of bad banks formed in the wake of the crisis and never managed to pull it off. Do you seriously think a group of that size, I think its assets are worth well over $5 billion US dollars, can this realistically be privatized by the government in the next 4 years?
Of course, it's a big size, so there could be many stakeholders, interest groups. So some leadership we need, some leadership we can trust. So this is a very political decision, but without political decision, there could be a war of all against all. So this is really undesirable for the Korean economy. We cannot waste time anymore. And someone should decide who can be trusted by people. It could be the president, or it could be the Blue House.
Well, let's hope that strong leadership becomes apparent in the next months and possibly the next years. Professor Lee, it's been a pleasure having you on Bizline. Thank you very much indeed for your time and expertise.
Thank you very much.
It's been a delight. Thank you. Voice recognition software has been with us for years, but unfortunately it has always been plagued by the techno-linguistic gremlins. Will the technology inside, say, a GPS navigator or a music service provider ever be able to recognize a person with an unusual voice or a thick accent? Will a computer ever be able to accurately render voice into text? The answers to these questions, in fact, are yes. In our ICT segment, we'll be taking a look at how leaps and bounds in voice recognition software technologies may soon be making the keyboard a thing of the past.
Open Sesame is no longer a magic word of a storybook. Now people live in the world where voice control has become commonplace. Let's have a close look at speech recognition technology that could lead to innovation in a way of using devices with improved accuracy of speech recognition in the era of smart technology. Studies over speech recognition technologies started to produce tangible outcomes from the 1970s, but it was still too early to commercialize the related technologies because of poor recognition accuracy. But speech processing technology has recently made major strides. Typing a keyboard is no longer necessary for browsing the internet or sending messages, which can now be done by voice commands. Speech recognition also helps find out a title of a song by matching a melody that a person is humming to the song sharing the same frequencies. As well, voice recognition has made conversation with foreigners in different Korean dialects possible.
음성 인터페이스는 사용자가 원하는 서비스를 편리하게 사용할 수 있도록 하는, 즉 사용성을 높일 수 있는 주목받는 몇 가지 기술 중에 하나입니다. 또한 음성 인식의 기술적 진보가 소형 멀티미디어 기기에서 사용자 요구를 처리할 수 있을 만큼 인식 성능이라든지 처리 속도가 제공되고 있기 때문에 동작 인식과 더불어 굉장한 주목을 받고 있습니다.
Such big improvements in the speech recognition technologies have been made following the development of the telecommunication technology. Voice-activated services operate based on a network. For example, input speech is compared to a database in a server to find the closest match through an analysis process. In other words, the accuracy of speech recognition is determined by the size of a database, as the recognition accuracy can improve by instantly matching the input speech in a server with the enormous speech database. Voice recognition has emerged as a mainstream technology these days, as mobile devices are getting smaller and equipped with various functions, making difficult for end users to operate features. Speech processing technology, which is based on the most convenient and natural user interface, is received well not only by general people, but also by the elderly and the disabled, who experience difficulty in operating the devices. Despite the developments of the telecommunication technologies leading to the advancements in speech recognition technology, electronic devices with voice-activated functions have failed to achieve a 100% recognition rate.
주변에 잡음이 있거나 다른 소리가 섞여 있는 경우에는 입력되는 신호가 미리 학습된 모델과 크게 차이가 나도록 만들기 때문에 인식률이 저하가 되게 됩니다. 그래서 음성 인식의 성능을 올리기 위해서는 반드시 이러한 잡음이나 주변의 다른 소리를 제거해 주어야만 합니다. 약 500m 마포대교
북단에서 Operating a navigation system in the middle of driving can cause an accident, but now it has become more handy and easy with a voice-activated functions installed in the car navigation system to offer a safe driving experience.
가까운 주유소
분석 중입니다.
With much improved accuracy of speech recognition, it is now possible to control various functions on a car navigation system, such as direction guide and a multimedia system only by speaking.
인식률 100%에 가깝게 된다면 차량 운전 중에 차량 내 모든 제어를 음성 인식으로만 할 수 있게 되겠죠. 이런 기술적인 연구는 구글의 무인 자동차 프로젝트가 대표적입니다. 구글에서는 5년 내에 무인 자동차를 실판매할 수 있을 거라고 하고 있습니다. 무인으로 자동 항법 장치에 의해서 운전하고 클라우드 통신과 접속되어 일상의 모든 서비스를 차량 내에서 처리할 수 있게 된다면 자동차는 단순한 기계가 아닌 인간을 대신하는 지능형 개인 서비스가 될 수도 있을 것 같습니다.
Studies on speech synthesis have been underway along with the speech recognition technology. This is not a human voice delivering a tearful monologue, but electric sound created by speech synthesis technology. Speech synthesis technology converts language text into speech, and this is a key technology for ARS services such as phone directory and weather services. Thanks to constant efforts of researchers across the globe, more accurate and friendly speech recognition technologies that could understand the ambiguity of natural language processing will likely be introduced in the near future.
음성은 사람의 소통 방식에 있어서 가장 자연스러운 수단입니다. 그렇기 때문에 기계와 사람 간의 인터페이스에 있어서도 음성은 가장 편리한 인터페이스라고 할 수 있습니다. 스마트폰을 비롯한 많은 스마트 디바이스에서 지능형 인터페이스들이 많이 도입되고 있는데 미래의 이러한 지능형 인터페이스 중에 음성은 가장 중요한 부분을 차지하게 될 것입니다.
Voice recognition technology is expected to be used in a wide range of applications, and it won't likely take long before the electronic devices sporting a speech recognition technology could not only recognize and execute spoken commands, but also converse with humans.
Traditionally, Koreans would dry and store a range of foodstuffs, fish, vegetables, meat, prior to the winter. This means they were guaranteed a balanced diet in the lean months when fresh produce would not be available. Fast forward to the modern era, and it's difficult to see the continuance of this tradition. And this is problematic. It means we're losing a very significant chunk of our culinary heritage. But now, a new product has become available that is doing the work of the sun and the wind by enabling the drying and storage of food products in the modern kitchen. Let's meet this week's Hidden Champion.
Eating fresh seasonal food is an essential part of maintaining a healthy lifestyle. Homemade healthy food is becoming popular amid the well-being trend. especially since there is growing concern over various environment issues and food-related accidents, as well as poor food quality. Dried food is joining the ranks of other foods such as organic, fermented, as well as healthy food. This is Shin Yun-sun, a housewife who is always interested in healthy living, which is why she is concerned about the kind of meal and snack she prepares for the family. After much thought, she decided to get a food drying machine, and now she enjoys dried food. She says using dried vegetables and fruits reduces meal preparation time, which has made cooking a lot easier.
둘째 아이가 아토피인데 간식을 아무거나 먹을 수 없잖아요. 근데 그렇다고 제가 직접 계속 간식을 만드는 게 쉽지가 않고 그래서 이제 건조기를 보고 건조를 해서 먹이다 보니까 아이가 잘 먹고 또 만들기도 쉽고 해서 사용을 많이 하게 되었어요.
It's easier to eat a healthy meal when dried ingredients becomes part of cooking, especially since dried food comes from the freshest produce that are in season.
일단은 아이들 먹거리에 염려가 좀 없어졌고요. 그다음에 남는 음식이 없으니까 경제적으로도 많이 도움이 되는 것 같아요.
Lee Quip is a Korean medium-sized firm that makes food drying machines. The company specializes in well-being small home appliances that are made in Korea. Lee Quip's product has gained the number one position in the domestic market with an 80% market share. Lee Quip introduced Korea's first food drying machine in 2005. The idea for the machine came from the traditional method of drying seasonal ingredients, which in the past was done at home.
가족의 건강을 생각하는 부지런한 30-40대의 가정주부, 그분들이 저희 고객의 제일 두터운 층입니다. 원하시는 매우 다양한 방법들로 저희 제품을 사용을 하고 계셔서 이게 그냥 만들어서는 되는 일이 아니고요. 그분들의 그 여러 가지 요구에 적합하게끔 만들었어야 됐기 때문에 계속 개선시킬 수밖에 없었던 거죠, 제품을.
The method of the food drying machine is in transforming the cool air from the outside into warm wind, so the ingredients are dried in a short period of time, which is referred to as the convection current heating system. The outside air goes through an air filter, which filters out harmful material in the air, creating a sanitary condition during the drying process. The food drying machine preserves fruit and vegetables in a dried state to be consumed in a convenient way. The variety is numerous.
식품 가공기를 할 수 있는 음식은 너무 광범위합니다. 너무 광범위하기 때문에 제가 뭐라 단정지을 수는 없지만 나물이나 고기, 뭐 육포, 뭐 어류까지 다 사용할 수 있는 부분 그 제품이기 때문에 상당히 사용하는데 편리한 제품입니다.
The food drying machine provides both convenience and nutrition. The product is energy efficient since electricity bill is at around 200 won even after 10 hours of use, which is a huge advantage for any user. Lee Quip's success didn't happen overnight, and there is a reason why the company focuses on quality and technology. There was a recall incident of some 8,000 of its products due to faulty imported motors.
좀 가격을 낮춰서 조금 낮출 수 있으면 낮춰서 우리가 이익을 좀 조금 더 얻자 했던 것이었는데 결과적으로는 어떤 내구성 기준이 있는데 그 부분에 크게 미치지 못했어요. 그래서 저희가 그때 당시 한 8,000대 정도 만들었던 것들을 전량 회수하기 위해서 노력을 많이 했고요. 그래서 그 이후로는 저희가 부품 수급에 있어서는 철저하게 그 국내에서만 부품을 수급하는 기준을 세우고 있습니다.
The company's quality management based on trust leads to product advancement, which also leads to an explosive consumer demand. We visited a store to find out about the consumer reaction towards the Lee Quip food drying machine.
이제 국내 판매 시작한 지 몇 년 안 되는데 최근에 들어서 많은 분들이 많이 찾으시고 확실히 저희가 오프라인 실행사나 이런 걸 하다 보면은 전에 열 분 중에 한두 분이 아셨다면 지금 대부분 주부들이 많이 아시는 그렇게 또 모신 분들도 옆에 분들이 다 설명이 가능할 정도로 많이 관심 있게 찾는 상품입니다.
There is growing interest among housewives about the food drying machine amid increasing interest in homemade dried food. The growing popularity comes with the convenience of the product, which dries food in a sanitary state, unlike the traditional way of drying ingredients.
아무래도 햇볕에 말리게 되면 이제 비가 오거나 뭐 그러면 이제 걷어야 되고 또 이제 요즘 공기도 안 좋기 때문에 이제 자연에서 말리는 건 조금 어려울 것 같고요. 저렇게 위생적으로 말릴 수 있으니까 시간도 절약되고 굉장히 좋을 것 같아요.
The best marketing is in achieving the best level in product quality. We expect to see a giant leap from the Korean company that has set a goal to make the world's leading food drying machine. The company has a rosy outlook on the market that is being dominated by the well-being and health-related trend.
June 25th is one of the blackest days in Korea's long and bloody history. On that date in 1950, the apocalyptic Korean War was unleashed across the peninsula. In the six decades since, the two Koreas have moved in opposite directions, deepening and broadening the divide between the two states. And nowhere is that divide deeper or broader than in the economic sphere. In our retrospective report, we'll be taking a look at the rise and the catastrophic fall of North Korea's economy.
The war was devastating. It resulted in over 1.2 million deaths of soldiers and civilians and laid the Korean peninsula in ashes, especially the northern region.
북한 경제가 거의 석기 시대 수준으로 돌아갔다 이렇게 이야기를 하거든요.
Post-war recovery was different in two Koreas, which went their separate ways, one democratic and the other communist. While the democratic South stagnated in the first post-war decade, the communist North bounced almost right back up. In August 1953, the North Korean elites decided to pour all possible efforts into post-war reconstruction. First, they worked on nationalization of the commerce and industries, as well as on cooperativization of farms.
53년도 8월 달에 결정이 되고 사실상 58년도에 가면 다 완료가 돼 버립니다. 그래서 그 상업과 공업 같은 경우는 100% 국영화되고요. 협동 농장도 58년경에 가면 100% 협동 농장으로 바뀌게 됩니다. 사유 재산이 없어지는 것이죠.
이데올로기도 있지만 또 실제 국가가 가장 중요한 생산 요소인 토지를 수용을 함에 따라서 일정 정도 경제적 그 복구 기반을 국가가 주도권을 쥐고 장악을 했다는 거 하나.
Secondly, the communist bureaucrats adopted the heavy industry first strategy.
중공업의 모든 인베스트먼트를 하고 나머지는 이제 labor mobilization, 그러니까 대중을 동원을 해서 그 이 경공업과 그다음에 농업을 발전시킨다는 얘긴데 어느 정도 성공할 수 했다고 볼 수가 있는데요. 북한을 방문한 존 로빈슨이라는 그 아주 유명한 경제학자가 있습니다. 이분이 1962년도에 북한을 방문하고 대동강의 기적이라고 할 정도로 북한의 경제가 매우 크게 성장을 했다고 볼 수가 있습니다.
But it would have been impossible without massive assistance from the Soviet Union, China and the Eastern European Communist bloc. Another contributing factor to the North's economic flourish after the war was mass mobilization method, also known as the Cholima movement.
내부 자원과 또 이 주민들의 자발적인 어떤 열정 이런 것을 동원해 가지고 경제를 건설하자 이런 운동입니다. 그래서 이게 이제 56년 말에 시작이 됐는데 초반에 굉장한 성과를 냅니다.
지주 세력들이 남한으로 대거 그 이제 탈북을 한 거죠. 당시에 국가 동원 체제가 가능했다는 거. 그래서 국가가 목표로 한 어떤 산업 정책 또는 산업 전략에 대해서 북한 주민들이 그 거의 뭐 어떤 저항도 없이 완벽하게 동원이 되었다는 거.
For the first couple of decades, the North Korean economy performed much better than its southern counterpart, recording up to 30% of economic growth.
토지와 인력이 있고 또 인프라가 있고 3개의 구성 요건들이 어떤 기본적인 환경을 조성해 줬던 게 초기 단계에서는 북한 경제 회복, 복구에 기여를 했다라고 저는 생각합니다.
However, all of the post-war economic strategies went quickly to the wall.
문제는 뭐냐면 그것이 일정 기간 동안에 가능한 것이지 indefinite하게 무한정 갈 수가 없다는 게 문제가 되겠죠.
Self-contradiction of socialism was evident. The planned economy reached its limits, labor force was exhausted, and the infrastructure and facilities started to deteriorate.
북한 경제의 어떤 잠재 성장력을 떨어뜨린 결정타는 뭔가 하면 1962년 12월에 역시 노동당 중앙회의 전원회의가 열려서 경제국방 병진 노선이라는 걸 선택을 합니다.
The goal of the Pyongjin policy was to simultaneously develop the economy and national defense amid international political turmoil such as the Sino-Soviet conflict and Cuban Missile Crisis. So 20-30% of the government budget went to national defense.
남한에서 군사 쿠데타가 일어나서 굉장히 강력한 어떤 그런 군사 정부가 들어섰다는 거죠. 그래서 국방에도 이제 힘을 쏠 수밖에 없었고 그래서 굉장히 어려운 상황이었지만 그런 병진 정책, 경제와 국방을 같이 가는 병진 정책을 쓸 수밖에 없었습니다. 근데 그거는 또 하나의 아까 우리가 전에 말씀드렸던 그 경제 취약함을 더욱더 가중시키는 그러한 거라고 볼 수가 있습니다.
In order to offset the strain of the military budget on the economy, North Korea decided to engage in massive borrowing from foreign markets.
72년부터 75년 정도까지 북한이 당시 돈으로 한 10억 달러 정도의 차관을 도입을 해요. 자본주의권 국가로부터. 근데 이게 이제 75년도 이때 가면 뭐가 생기는가 하면 오일쇼크가 생기잖아요. 오일쇼크가 생기면서 수출도 안 되고 뭐 여러 가지 문제가 생기면서 북한이 75년도에 외화 상환 불능, 그러니까 디폴트 선언을 하게 되죠. 그래서 이후에 이제 자본주의권과의 경제 관계는 다 끊기게 되는 거죠.
The communist economy finally entered into the state of never-ending stagnation. Then the collapse of the Soviet Union and the communist bloc in Eastern Europe in the early 90s struck a fatal blow to North Korea.
91년에 이제 소련이 앞으로는 경화 결제를 해라, 달러 결제를 해달라 이렇게 얘기를 해요. 북한 달러가 전혀 없으니까 소련과의 무역이 갑자기 단절돼 버립니다. 그리고 중국도 92년부터 경화 결제를 해달라라고 얘기를 합니다. 이런 식으로 북한 경제 자체가 올스탑해 버리는 거죠. 일순간에.
There have been and will be turning points for North Korea to straighten out its almost disintegrated economy.
북한 논리가 성립을 하려면 북한의 대외 안보 환경이 개선이 돼야 되는 거죠. 근데 이제 그게 아니라 지금처럼 계속 이제 안보 환경이 나쁘고 악화된다면 북한은 이제 핵무기 숫자를 더 늘려야 되고 뭐 또 위성도 쏴 올려야 되고 이런 일들을 계속 해야 되는 것이죠.
그 한 50년 동안 겪어왔던 어떤 북한 경제 정책의 방향이라든가 전략을 가만히 들여다보면 앞으로의 미래가 약간은 예측은 되는 거죠. 시행착오를 겪더라도 그걸 극복을 하고 최고 지도층이 그걸 감내하고 넘어설 수 있는 용기가 있어야 되는데 그런 측면 몇 가지를 보면 김정은 체제에서 힘들지 않을까.
When such opportunities knock, don't hesitate to open the door. If they don't, then build a door to open, not to close.
And that is all we have time for on Bizline this week. But do stay with us because next Friday we'll be assessing the outcome of the critical China-Korea summit. We'll be looking at the economic and business side of that. We'll also be looking at a new technology that enables the recharging of electric devices without a power cable. So we'll hope to see you next week. It's been a pleasure having you with us this week. As always, I'm Andrew Salmon. This was Bizline. Goodbye.